Welcome back to my channel. This video is going to be a little different from what I normally do, which is like tutorials, lookbooks. So I wanted to let you guys know that I have opened a sticker business. So a lot of my time during COVID has been jobless and just not figuring out, I guess, what to do during this time, especially me moving back to Vancouver. So I have decided to start my own sticker business. I actually had a kind of like a business before on Society6, which is a site where you can upload your designs and you'll be able to sell your designs on products that they provide for you. But I found that I didn't really get much profit from that. So I've been doing a lot of TikTok and I've been seeing a lot of people uploading their own stickers, their own like small businesses. So I was like, okay, like why not? I don't think it could be that hard. I was kind of wrong. So I just want to walk you guys through the process and how I did it. First, I had my initial designs at first, but I realized I definitely needed to step up my designs, create new ones, and just update like the flaws of some of them. So after designing a couple, I was like, okay, I need to start my Etsy business. I decided to sell on Etsy and get my printer. So I did not have a printer at all. It would only be black and white. So I decided to buy a printer of color, and then after that I decided to have a small soft opening. So after uploading my designs and just printing, I realized that I definitely needed a lot of work to put into it. Just cause like you don't know how much like paper costs, you don't know what material you should get, or just like how high quality your product should be. So that was definitely a trial and error. I got most of my products from either Michaels or my sticker paper I ordered from a site called Online Labels. I actually learned a lot from watching other businesses on TikTok and just their tips to make their business successful. So after that, I had my friends help me and support me by helping me start off, which was great, except for they are not my target audience, so I can't always depend on them. After that, I felt like, you know, things weren't really taking off as I wanted to, but I didn't give up. I did not have the right sticker paper, so I had to correct that, and I spent a whole lot of time just cutting out my stickers by hand because I thought I could do it. I was like, oh yeah, like I don't need like this Cricut machine that everybody's been buying. It's like way too expensive and I can just do this by myself. But as soon as I got orders from people that weren't my friends, I kind of started panicking. So I ended up buying a waterproof paper, which was the right paper to use, and then after cutting with my hands for so many times, I couldn't do it anymore. It like hurt, the cuts weren't precise, and I was just not satisfied with my product. So in the end, I ended up buying a Cricut, which I said I was not going to do, but I ended up doing it because I felt, you know, once I start my business, I can like make that profit back to pay off the Cricut. And overall, it's been pretty good. There's definitely some trial and errors with using a Cricut, like just alignment and just what mode to put it on. So that was definitely fun to try to use. And I definitely started seeing a lot of orders come in, which was really surprising to me. So you could tell that it wasn't as hard as I expected, but there are some bumps and kinks along the way, so you just gotta somehow figure it out. And then after that, there were still a little times where I didn't necessarily do well. So there would be days where you don't have sales at all, but definitely what I've learned is to join a Etsy group on Facebook just to get help and support from other buyers. A lot of other buyers like to help you support your own business, so it's kind of like, you buy my product, I'll buy your product. And that definitely helped boost up my sales. It's been two, three months that I've started the business, and surprisingly, I got around 150 sales, which is not a lot, but to me, it's crazy because I've never thought it would be this big, like before. But I'm very glad that it turned out the way it is, and I wanted to share you guys my process of how I started this. If you have any questions, please let me know below, and I would be more than likely happy to respond to you. If you guys love Asian stickers, Asian boba snacks, please check out my store below. I'll leave the link in the comments. And I'm definitely improving every single day, just trying to figure out what's the best material, what designs are trending, and what I want my brand to be in this, I guess, small business. So I'm glad that you guys have helped me and supported me throughout all this process. And please don't forget to leave any comments if you are looking for certain stickers. I'm definitely open to making them and just expanding my creative designs. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!